every time I'm with Nipsey, we not talking about no nothing that don't mean nothing. We always talking about goals, family, homies, plays we trying to make. Like I was having conversations with Nip about, I'm like, look, bro, we got some light-skinned, pretty girls we got to raise. We in trouble, my nigga. What we going to do? You know what I'm saying?
Hey, you guys. So you guys just saw that clip from YG that has a lot of people feeling some sort of way. A lot of people are canceling him because of what he had to say. Obviously, YG felt comfortable saying that because he has been making statements like that before in the past. And I want to go ahead and touch on times that YG has been problematic. I don't really plan to cover the Nipsey memorial, but I will be discussing what YG had to say because obviously it has overshadowed Nipsey's memorial. So if you guys want to see other times that YG have said color struck things before in the past, please stay tuned for the rest of this video. This video is sponsored by CarMarshal. They have over 100,000 cars in their inventory. While you shop, they will negotiate for you. I'll provide the link for you to go click and search for your new vehicle today. Simply K Inc., your skincare solution for all of your skincare related problems. Simply K Inc. has a solution for you. AshKickin.com, whether you need incense, personal hygiene products, candles, car fresheners, AshKickin is your go to. Please visit AshKickin.com. Use Paris Milan at checkout to receive 15% off. This video is also sponsored by Soulfully Scented LV. They are a black owned hair care line that has very affordable products that are also very potent. Please go to soulfullyscentedlv.com. Rapper YG is from Compton, California, and he put himself on the map after his song Tuna and Buddha became a hit. Even though he started to achieve success, there were times in his life where he had been shot. He was shot about 7 years ago in January during the set of him filming a music video, and about 4 years ago he was shot yet again, and he survived it, but he discussed how his therapist played a role in his healing, as well as his mother, who is a darker skinned black woman. And I'm sure some of you are gonna be like, well, his mother is darker skinned, how can he feel this way? But I will go into detail more towards the end of this. He is 29 years of age, and he has a daughter who is named Harmony with a woman named Caitlin. His daughter is light skinned, and this has been a basis of him making a lot of statements that have been very colorist and that has caused people to side eye him the way that he fetishizes his daughter's skin tone. Let me be clear, there's a difference between describing your child as being light-skinned and worshiping them for the sake of it. And what he does is overly worships her skin tone for being light, when you should just be happy that a child is healthy regardless of their skin tone. And I'm sure some of you are gonna think, why do you feel that he doesn't like black women? Well, that brings us to number one, his song Grind Mode that he made in 2012. And I don't care that the song was 7 years ago, he still holds the same mentality. He said, riding real slow with a black A tint, N-word can't stand no black AB. Clearly in rap, it's very misogynistic, especially in terms of misogynoir. Rarely do you hear them downgrade lighter skin or mixed women. And I'm not saying that they should downgrade those women, but what I am saying is that if you don't care about us, if we are beneath you and you can't stand us, why are we always the topic of your conversations? They will rip us to the core in these songs. And so when you hear him talk about he can't stand no black AB, please believe that that's not him using his artistic value in this song. That's really how he feels. And it also is why every time he gets a chance to get on a platform, he's talking about light skin this and this is pretty light skin that. Now let's move on to number two, where he was at Hot 97 and they were discussing his daughter, and he goes ahead and points out the fact that she's light skin, even though it's already a given.
How you like this dad life?
Oh, I love it. I love.
It's the best, right?
Yeah.
So you had a little girl or a son?
Little girl.
A little girl, and she's so cute. Girl,
yeah, Laura's always talking about how cute his daughter.
I know.
Light skin, baby.
Nah, don't do that. Don't start this.
Hey,
don't
why talk. Everybody tell me don't do that?
Because it's the complexion thing with black people. It's a sore spot, man. It's a sore spot.
I mean, it's regular for me.
How different is she in skin tone from you?
She looks like a little Asian baby.
Yeah, now white people can't ask.
What I'm saying is the point is it funny, like when you look at your kid and your kid is like, that's not something that white people have, right? You're generally all the same skin tone. In a black family, everyone could look different.
Facts.
So, like, your child looks somewhat different than you.
Yeah, yeah.
But I'm sure, YG, you got light-skinned family members. You black. You black and from L.A. You got some light-skinned family members with some light eyes or something. Somebody got some green eyes and some good hair or something.
Yeah, that.
That whole conversation always happened, right? Yeah. The good hair, right? Everybody hates that conversation, too. Yeah. Sensitive spot.
Yeah, you shouldn't even use that term, you bro.
That's so freaking embarrassing to me. This is like the second time that I've seen a situation where a white man has sit in on the conversation of colorism and they've checked a black man or a mixed race man. Just like with the Yes Jewel situation, the white man that was sitting beside them kind of was more so trying to take a logical approach. And even in this case, Rosenberg, he told Ebro with that whole light skin, good hair thing that he shouldn't even say that. Hosts were feeling uncomfortable, like, what is the point of you bringing that up? You already know it's like a sensitive spot with the black community. And YG is just oblivious. He just doesn't care. He's like, okay, well, that's normal for me. They're placing these babies on the platform on the basis of their skin tone, not because they're talented, not because they're intelligent, not because they're making strides in terms of their development. They're simply doing this because the baby is light skinned. And again, he just has continued to do this in his music. Now let's go on to number three. He again praises the light skin and talks about what he wants on this song called On the Set featuring Tory Lanez. So he says, I want you girl, baby, I want you girl, let that young G hit you, let a YG get with you, light skin, slim fit, curly hair. So again, this is YG bringing up the fact that this is a light-skinned person, pretty light-skinned babies, I don't like no dark AB. Now let's move on to number four. There's a song called Bad B by him, and he says, now that's a bad B, and she remind me of a top model diva, light-skinned skinny B, she remind me of Eva. Now let's move on to number five. He was featured on this song called Light Skin by 16 Bars. If these men made these statements and black women were allowed to move accordingly the way that I have moved in these situations where black men have said things or mixed race men have said things and I don't come out and speak out, you guys complain. And what I mean by complaining is that you get mad when I do not show these very men support. You guys tell us all day that these men making statements about dark-skinned black women is a matter of preference, they're allowed to say anything about you and that you should ignore it and that you shouldn't say anything. Well, for example, with my case, this is how I personally move. If I have heard that a black man to this day or a mixed race man or whatever race has said something about black women, I don't support him. I'm not going to promote him. I don't care what happens to him. I'm not going to lower my self-esteem and allow people to consistently make disparaging comments, always disguise it as jokes in terms of black women. Those days are over. Now, I'm sure some of you guys are going to say, why are you focusing on the negative? YG doesn't represent us. You should be asking him, why did he make these statements? You can hear how silent people were. Why was that your first instinct to go ahead and make those statements? Also, you guys are hypocrites. You're going to sit over here and say YG doesn't represent us, but let him get shot or let something happen to him. You guys are gonna get in my inbox cussing me out about why I didn't make a video on how I don't support black men. So which one is it? Does he represent you when he owns a business or he makes some sort of strive for the black community or something bad happens to him where he needs black women support? He represents you then, but let him say something colorist, which a lot of y'all seem to have this mindset. I'm not gonna say all, but a lot of y'all do. And all of a sudden, no, that don't relate to me. That don't represent me. Some of you guys who don't get it are being very hypocritical, because if this was a black woman and specifically a dark-skinned black woman making these anti-black men statements, y'all don't give a F if she was shot 11,000 times. Y'all would not in droves be trying to force black men to go out and support her. You'd be giving us all type of excuses on why she deserved to get shot, or even see when these black women get stomped out. You guys are always trying to justify it. It's hypocritical when you guys make these justifications when these women have not made any anti-black male statements, but let these men make anti-black woman statements and you have every excuse in the book for why black women still need to support these men. And I've already stated on my channel that it is partially black women's fault for tolerating this disrespect. Black women have not demanded enough standards with these men. We have allowed these men to talk crazy to us for so many years. Even in terms of our dating practices, we do not set ample standards. And this is why these men are able to say X, Y, and Z about us. And oh, I hate that dumb black B, and I can't stand no dark AB, F that dark AB. You dark Bs bring dark days. And guess what? After they make these statements, after they've already had the tweets exposed and the videos exposed, guess who they look to in order to support them again? Dark-skinned black women. And the reason why that happens is because black women too many times have allowed themselves to be considered a person of convenience and not a person to value. When you get something that is so convenient for you, it depreciates in value. And so therefore, a person doesn't feel like they have to strive to get it because they know that you're going to be there because they've taken you for granted and you've allowed yourself to be taken for granted. I'm encouraging black women to change up the dynamics of the relationships that they have with certain black men. Now again, if you have to be willing to counsel certain black artists, you have to be willing to do that. But for the sake of your self-esteem to the freaking world, can you put your foot down for once? If you're with a man that's talking about your hair texture is too kinky, or he uses the word nappy, and he's talking about your nose is too big, and your eyes ain't green, and this ain't silky enough, and your skin ain't light enough, don't have no baby with him. I've heard of too many black women hearing men make statements like this, and they still try to work it out and try to ignore it. No, you're effing with the colorist. If you hear a man in his song talking about F that dark skin, black bee, you black bees ain't this or that. Don't listen to his music. I remember one time there was this guy trying to sell his CDs on a BART one time in front of me. You know, he was talking to this Asian girl. Sometimes these Asian girls, especially from the Bay Area, be wearing these blue contacts and stuff. And he was like, wow, your skin is so pretty and light and your eyes are blue. Mind you, he did not one time ask her to buy a CD to make a contribution. But here he comes over to me. Hey, sister, you think you could help a brother out making a few dollars to my CD? I'm like, get the F out. You better ask her. And that's how it has to be. Black women, stop being the cleanup women. Let these mixed race, these non-black women go ahead and support these men, and let's see how far their careers go. They have been able to build their careers on our backs. We've carried their careers and they don't require nothing out of these women, and these women end up reaping the benefits. Too many of us have platforms to warn you guys about the dangers of supporting these men like this, and if you want to get on the bandwagon of allowing these men to consistently disrespect you and you constantly being unprotected, you have the right to continue to beg these men to love you and all that, but I'm not doing that anymore. I refuse to ever sit back and allow a grown man to disrespect me when he's under the same system of white supremacy and is in no better position being a black man in the society than I am. And just watch how the industry will move. Yeah, they'll let these people talk about it on Twitter and all that, but are they gonna pull a Kodak Black stunt where they cancel their songs from being played on the radio? Are these gangsters and these rappers and industry black men gonna come out and jump on YG for it? No, they're probably gonna be silent until he says something about mixed race or non-black women, and then they're going to completely cancel him. So anyways, you guys, let me know what you feel about YG's colorist comments. Are you canceling YG for this? Did you know he made these statements? Please make sure you like, comment, subscribe, and share, and I'll talk to you guys in my next video. Bye!